Hello, my name is Keshwani.
That's K-E-S-H-W-A-N-I,
Keshwani. We are here because we want to prepare for the TEAS. We have been solving math problems out of this book here, the ATI study manual, the sixth edition. If you do not own this book already, purchase one immediately. You're going to need it. Today is our lesson number 127. We are on page number 79. Problem number 2 is what we're going to solve. If you decide, after watching this video, you decide that this is helpful, and if you decide that you want to get some more practice to better prepare yourself for the exam, you will find that we have solved all the problems that appeared in the previous edition, the fifth edition that I'm holding in my hand, and you will find the solutions to all of the problems that appeared in this book from day number 1 through 80. Avail yourself to those videos if you so wish. Let's get going. And also, after having watched the video, you decide that it is helpful and you want to work with me on an individual basis, I provide one-to-one online private tutoring. There's my phone number, 1-800-808-PREP. There's my email address, prepsat@aol.com. And there's the rate, $40 per hour as of today. Let's get going. Number 2. In number 2, we have a gentleman by the name of Carl. And Carl wants to move to either Flagstaff, a place called Flagstaff, or a place called Phoenix, Arizona. Phoenix, I know, is in Arizona. I don't know where the hell Flagstaff is. We are told that Phoenix has an average of 4,041 hours of sunlight per year. We are also told that Flagstaff has an average of 10 hours and 58 minutes per day. The guy wants to move where he can get more sunshine. Notice how I finished my sentence? Not most sunshine, more sunshine, because we're comparing only two places. If we had been comparing more than two places, then we would have said he wants to move to a place where he has a chance of getting the most sunshine. The combination is only between the two. Therefore, one employs comparative and not superlative. Where can he move so that he can have a chance of having more sunshine? F or P? Well, they made a really big fuss about how they went about it. I'm going to show you a more clear, straightforward approach first before we worry about looking at the answer choices. And when something like this appears in the exam, even though they tell you 10 hours 58 minutes, it does not mean that you have to sit there like a bloody puppet and actually work with 10 hours and 58 minutes. Take some liberties. Cut the strings. Don't be a bloody puppet. Let's pretend, for the sake of simplicity, that this is 11 hours. And let's watch what happens. If you're going to pretend that it is 11 hours, we have 365 days in a year. 365 days in a year. And we are told 11 hours per day of sunshine. Let's see what we get. Let's see what we can get. We're going to multiply this quantity by 11. Okay, are you ready? Let's get going. 11 times 5. 11 5s are 55. 11's table is very easy. 11 ones are 11, 11 twos are 22, 11 threes are 33, 44, 55, 66, 77, 88, 99, so on and so forth. It's very simple, up until 9. And that's all we're going to need. because we are multiplying by 5, 6 and 3, so we can multiply it in one shot. 11 times 5 is 55. 55, 5, 35. 11, 6 is 66. 66 plus 5, 66 plus 5, 65 plus 5 would have been 70. Therefore, 66 plus 5 would be 71.
1, carry 7.
11 times 3 is 33. 33 plus 7 is going to be 40.
As you can see,
this comes out to be 4,115. That is clearly less than 4,041. What's the unit here? The unit here is going to come from multiplying
this unit by that unit. We're going to do it on the side here so you can see. 365 days per year. 365 days per year.
If you're going to go into nursing school, it's very important that you know how to manipulate your units, because without the proper knowledge of units, you can potentially kill a patient, that is, which is generally not a good idea if the patient has not yet paid the bill. So 365 days per year, and this is 11 hours per day.
11 hours per day. Watch what happens.
The day is going to cancel out, and we are left with hours per year, which is exactly what we want. This represents 4,015 hours of sunshine per year, which is what this was. 4,441 hours of sunlight per year. You see, same unit. You can clearly see that this is 4,015 hours, this is 4,040 hours, fixed about, I guess, about 26 more hours per year of sunshine. 26 more hours more per year of sunshine. It's like getting one extra day of sunshine. Actually, two extra days of getting sunshine. It's 26 hours, let's pretend it's 24 hours, and 24 hours will count as 2 days, because a day is defined as 12 hours of sunshine in the problem. In the problem, they tell you that they are assuming 12 hours of sunshine per day. So 26 hours is getting more than 2 days of sunshine. Clearly, he should move to Phoenix. Now let's look at the answer choices. We already know that Phoenix wins. We know that Phoenix wins. It wins by almost 26 hours. Let's do the problem now. Because we have to figure out which answer choice to pick. We already know we want to pick the answer choice that says Phoenix, but which one? Let's look at answer choice A.
A says, and I'm going to put the entire thing on the blackboard verbatim, and you will see the reason in a second. A says 4,041 hours is more than 10 hours, 58 minutes. So pick Phoenix.
What is wrong with this answer choice? Or is this the right answer? The answer to that question is, this is not the right answer, this is not the correct answer. What is wrong with it is that it is missing something. It's missing, the units are either not there or they're not complete.
Had it said 4,041 hours per year is more than 10 hours 58 minutes per day, then it would have been the right answer.
It would have been the correct answer. But that's not what it says. It's missing, as I said, either the units completely in the second part. It says 10 hours 58 minutes. There are no units at all. And here the units are partial. It says 4,041 hours per year. But simply saying that 4,041 hours is more than 10 hours and 58 minutes, obviously 4,000 hours are more than 10 hours and 58 minutes, for crying out loud. That's not the reason why we want to pick it. That's not correct. It is wrong. We don't want to pick Phoenix because we know that 4,041 hours are more than 10 hours. That's absolute nonsense. I'm looking for my cap here before the tip dries. Let's look at answer choice B. That's why A is wrong. What does B say? answer choice B says
4,380 hours over 4,041 hours.
And then they go on to say that this quantity is equal to
1.08.
Well, I could make it very simple by telling you one reason why it's wrong, but I don't think that's the reason they had in mind, because they're just being lazy. It is wrong the way it's written.
They should have written this quantity is approximately equal to 1.08,
because it does not equal to exactly 1.08. But that's not the reason why they don't want you to pick it. As I said, they just don't use the word approximately here. They have a nasty habit of putting equal sign everywhere. It should say it's approximately equal to.
But this does not do anything at all.
Where are these numbers coming from? Well, 4,041 hours, we know, is the number of hours per year of sunshine we get in Phoenix. We know that. I believe it was Phoenix. 4,041. Yes. Where is the second number coming from? 4,380. Well, they're assuming 365 days per year, and they're assuming a maximum of 12 hours per day of sunshine. That's the max they're defining. If I stop being lazy and actually read it. Phoenix has an average of 4,041 hours of sunlight per year out of a possible 4,380 hours. And in the parentheses, they go on to explain 12 daylight hours per day times 365 per day. So those are the daylight hours. That's, in other words, that's the maximum amount of sunlight you can, sunshine you can have. Let's multiply this quantity, shall we? 12 times 5, 12 5s are 60. 12 5s are 60. 0, 36. 12 6s are, do you know your 12s table? If 12 5s are 60, and if you were to, if you like, 5 12s.
5 12s are 60. 5 12s are 60.
If 5 12s are 60, if I were to add one more 12, if I were to add one more 12 to it,
then 6 12s should be 12 more than this guy. 12 more than 60.
12 more than 60 is 72. So let's begin again. We're multiplying 12 times 5. 12 times 5. 5 12s are 60. 0, here is 6. 6 12s are 72. We just saw it here. 72 plus 6 is 78.
8, 37.
3 12s are 36. 3 12s are 36. 36 plus 7. 36 plus 7, if you split the 7 into 4 and a 3, 36 plus 4 is 40, plus a 3 is 43. That's where they're coming with this number. And again, if you do not like the multiplication the way I did it here, and if you want to do it in a babyish way, it's fine, there is nothing wrong with it. Just multiply 365 times 12, one digit at a time, and you will see this comes out to be the same thing. Multiply by 2 first, 2 times 5 is 10, 12 plus 1 is 13, carry 1, 6 and 7. Hold the unit digit, multiply by 1, so it's going to be 365. And if you add up, you're going to get 8, 13, there you go, you get the same thing. If you do it, as I say, the babyish way. Here I multiply by 12 in one shot, just like we did before when we multiplied by 11 in one shot. Instead of doing it in two steps, one and one. But the point still remains that this is just a ratio of maximum number of hours of sunshine in a given year over the number of sunshine hours in Phoenix. It does not do anything at all in terms of establishing where should I move, Phoenix or flagship, Flagstaff, whatever it was. It's just a ratio of maximum number of hours by the number of hours of sunshine we get in Phoenix. It doesn't do anything. It doesn't serve any purpose at all. It is true, if someone tells you that 4,380 divided by 4,041 is approximately equal to 1.08, well, it does warm the cockles of one's heart to learn that, but it really doesn't do anything in terms of our need here, which is to establish where should I move, Flagstaff or Phoenix. It doesn't serve the purpose. But it does, as I said, warm.
I'm putting it on the blackboard in case you're not familiar with the expression.
Warm
the cockles of one's heart.
When you tell me 4380 divided by 4041 is approximately equal to 1.08, I do feel warm and fuzzy. I feel very nice about it, but it doesn't serve any purpose. You understand? Let's look at C.
In answer to IC, they say 4,041 hours over 4,380 hours. What do you notice?
It is same as B. It is same as B. This answer
is same as B, except in the reciprocal form.
Except in the reciprocal form. If B did not serve any purpose, C is not going to serve any purpose either. Why? Why, you may ask? Well, there is a reason for it. And the reason is because if B did not provide us the necessary information, simply putting in a reciprocal form, it's not going to provide the information either. Again, it's just a ratio of the two numbers, of maximum numbers of hours of sunshine versus the number of hours of sunshine they get in Phoenix. It does no comparison with the Flagstaff. I'm going to share with you right now. So if this doesn't serve any purpose, this is just, I think the technical term used by mathematician is bullcrap. It doesn't serve any purpose. And this is the reciprocal of it. I'm going to share with you right now an equation now, which will help you pass the math portion of the TEAS, and it will perhaps also help you in the life as a whole, particularly if you're in a bar talking to a fellow. The equation goes something like this.
Reciprocal
of bullcrap
is still that's the equation.
Do you understand? It's not going to change anything. It is still bullcrap. It's just the reciprocal of it. Reciprocal of BS is still pile of BS. It doesn't change anything. Let's look at answer choice D. We need room. In answer choice D, we have
4,041 hours over 365 days, we are told.
Is equal to 11.07 hours per day.
Is equal to 11.07 hours per day.
First of all, it is wrong. If you do the math, if you take out the calculator and do the math, you will see that this quantity does not exactly equal to this quantity.
It is approximately equal to. It is mathematically, it is wrong to say it is equal to. It is not equal to. It is approximately equal to.
But at least now we are getting someplace. Now we are getting someplace because now we know how many hours of sunshine we get in Flagstaff. We get 11.07 hours per day, and or rather, this is Phoenix. So we know we get 11.07 hours per day, and the other one was. In the problem, they told us that we get 10 hours 58 minutes. There you go, we are done. We don't even have to convert this 0.07 hours We don't even have to worry about how many minutes that is. That's already 11 hours. And the other place was 10 hours 58 minutes. Since this is Flagstaff, since Flagstaff is 10 hours and 58 minutes, and Phoenix is already more than 11 hours, 11 hours and some minutes, Phoenix wins.
The answer is D.
The answer is D. Because the other place is 10 hours 58 minutes, this one is a little bit more than 11 hours. Now, if you want to find out exactly how many minutes is that, 0.07 hours, well, it's very simple. Multiply by 1. This is called multiplying it by 1. Why multiplying it by 1? Because how many minutes does an hour have? How many minutes does 1 hour have? 1 hour has 60 minutes. So 60 minutes that you see on the top is 1 hour. On the bottom we have 1 hour. So 1 hour divided by 1 hour is 1. This is just 1. So if you multiply quantity by 1, it doesn't change anything. But now we can get rid of the hours. Now we can get rid of the hours. And we see that 7 times 6, 7, 6 are 42. So you will find that it comes out to be 4.2 minutes. This thing is 11 hours and 4 minutes. This thing is 11 hours and 4 minutes. But like I said before, that wasn't necessary. That was a waste of time. It wasn't necessary. We can clearly see that it is already more than 11 hours, and that's less than 11 hours. We're going to move to Phoenix. Now that we have done the extra work, we can even go by this 0.07 hours, which is 4 minutes. We're going to move to Phoenix, because if we move to Phoenix, we get to enjoy 6 whole minutes of extra sunshine every day. And I want those 6 extra minutes of sunshine, which is why I solved that bloody problem. Otherwise, I wouldn't have solved it. I want my 6 more minutes of sunshine. Hola, I'm off to Phoenix. See you later.